This is really huge. This is really big. Please welcome America's Mayor, Rudy Giuliani.
Thank you. Thank you very much. 9/11.
I'm sorry, you're talking. You're talking over the applause. Hello.
All I said was thank. I just said thank you very much. 9/11. You know, usual gratuities or whatever you call them.
David,
it's a pleasure. I love the beard. Love the beard. Big fan. Big fan. Okay. Going all the way back to late night on NBC. You're the best.
No. This is David Feldman, not David Letterman.
David, I'm telling you, I've heard a lot of stuff about Conan this week. There's only one. There's only one, and it's you.
No, it's...
The one. Going back to the Just Bulbs. Remember that? When you went to Just Bulbs, that was...
Just Bulbs. Yeah, I did.
That was comedy.
I did go to
Those
Just
were
Bulbs.
The days. That's when things were funny.
No, Mr. America's
Me
Mayor.
Me after 9/11. Remember that?
I do.
When I talked to Lorne Michaels, when I was on stage with him? Right?
Yes.
Right?
You gave us permission.
Why start now? Remember that? Why start now?
That was.
It wasn't as funny as your stuff, Dave.
No, not at all. Yeah, but it was a great time.
You were the
best,
Letterman. Best.
Yeah. Great time for comedy back then. But I'm not David Letterman, Mr. America's Mayor.
Huh?
Not Letterman, Feldman. This is
You're
David.
A liar. You're a liar.
No, I'm not a liar. I'm David Feldman, not David Letterman.
Oh, right. Feldman.
Yes.
You're the CFO of Trump Enterprises.
No, that's Weisselberg, Alan Weisselberg.
Like I said, Feldman. Listen, how is Ivanka? Did she mention me?
I am not Alan Weisselberg.
I thought I had a shot.
You don't have a shot with her, Mr. America's Mayor. And I am not Alan Weisselberg, the CFO of Trump Enterprises. I am David Feldman. I have nothing to do with Donald Trump.
Oh, yeah. Right. Neither do I. Nothing. Now, Alan, right. While I have you on the phone, I never got reimbursed for some of those travel expenses, you know? The kind of expenses we agreed nobody should ever put in writing.
I am not Alan Weisselberg.
Of course, you're not. And I'm not Rudy Giuliani. But someone needs to make sure that a check for $45,000 is deposited into Old Red Eye's Cayman Island account. ASAP, stat, PDQ.
Mr. Giuliani, you know, we're in the middle of a very important show for Diabetic Fury.
Okay. Now,
you told us you have an important announcement.
Okay, all right. You got the check taken care of. I got the announcement.
It's Feldman, not Weisselberg.
Very exciting news, quote, yes. Feldman. That's good.
I'm not Alan
very
Weisselberg.
Very exciting news. I've decided to run for mayor of New York City. Can you believe it? Me, Rudy Giuliani, America's mayor, finally settling down with the city. I picked New York. It could have been any city, but America's mayor picked New York City.
Really? Mr. Giuliani, you want to be mayor of New York City?
Yes, I do.
Again?
Yes, I do.
Again?
What are you, going deaf? I said yes.
No, you've already been mayor. You already were mayor of New York City.
Okay. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Very funny, Dave. Very good. That's good. That's funnier than Mujab and Sirajul. That's good. That's good stuff. All right, listen to me. The election is in November, okay? But thank you for the optimism.
Why, Mr. America's mayor, why would you run for mayor of New York City at a time like this, especially with your plate so full? I mean, the New York bar is coming for you.
Which New York bar? I have settled every single one of those tabs.
America's mayor, is this the time in your life, Rudy Giuliani, to be running for office?
Absolutely. The city needs me.
But can you win?
Most certainly. I have a winning strategy. I'm running on fiscal responsibility.
Okay, that's interesting. Fiscal responsibility.
If people have spoken and they want fiscal responsibility, voters are sick and tired of the debt this city is racking up. All the ex-wives, the homes it had to sign over to my kids to avoid the taxes. Do you have any idea what this city spent last year in room service alone?
No.
I mean, it's out of control. Why does the city always get stuck with the room service tab? Everyone thinks I'm rolling in money because I'm working out of a hotel and not an office. Sure, let New York City pay for it. He makes $20,000 a day. That's only what New York City bills. But nobody ever pays me on time. New York has incredible overhead. You miss one alimony payment, and that bitch drags you into court, and you're paying for her lawyer. It's a total con job. New York is being taken for a sucker, and it has to stop. That's why I'm running for mayor. The spending is out of control.
Are you sure we're talking about New York City?
Yes, we are. What used to be the greatest city in the world. There was a time when New York City could walk into any bar, and never have to reach for its wallet. Hey, look, it's America's mayor, New York City. Your money's no good here. A round of bourbon and pickled eggs for the greatest city in the world. But now, I can't even get Sebastian Gorka to return New York City's call. That's what 8 years of Democratic leadership under Bill de Blasio has done. He has left this once great city a rambling, confused, wild-eyed mess.
So you're worried about New York City's finances.
Our books are a disaster. It's worse than anybody knows. Nobody can tell me where the money is gone. But it's gone. Disappeared. New York is probably going to have to move to New Jersey. And not even Hoboken. I'm going to have to move to friggin' Neptune, New Jersey.
Whoa. New York City might be moving to Neptune, New Jersey?
Yes, Neptune, New Jersey. Have you been to Neptune? It's a cultural cesspool. It should be called Uranus.
Oh, I get it. Uranus.
No, there actually used to be a Uranus, New Jersey. But it got folded into Bayonne.
I didn't know that.
There are a lot of things you don't know, kiddo. You know how embarrassing it is for an international hub like New York City to have to pull up stakes and relocate to a Philly suburb?
New York might have to move. That's right, to Neptune, New Jersey.
That's right. That's right, David. You want to live in Neptune, New Jersey? I don't. I told my son Andrew this morning that at least in prison, there are people I can talk to. People I have something in common with. Neptune, New Jersey? I'm telling you, it's a sad, starry state of affairs.
It sounds terrible. I haven't been following City Hall the way you have. Okay, so what kind of fiscal responsibility will you implement if you get elected mayor?
All right. First, we're going to up the mayor's salary to $3 million cash.
A year.
Plus performance bonuses.
Wait. How is that fiscal responsibility?
David, understand. New York City needs two working thumbs to compete in today's global economy. And trust me, there are multiple people out there coming for New York's thumbs. These people do not mess around, David. They want their money. And they will make an example out of New York City.
Okay, I get it. New York is broke.
More than just broke.
Okay.
I've never seen New York City this scared. I mean, in the past, it could always scrape together a gig, but these days it is hemorrhaging cash and nobody will return my calls.
Okay, Rudy Giuliani, besides fiscal, it sounds terrible for New York. I live here and you've got me terrified. Besides fiscal responsibility, what else are you offering voters like me?
I'm gonna clean up this town. Have you been to Times Square? It's nothing but live sex acts, porn that at the very least is bending the law. Pimps in giant fur coats, peep booths where they claim you get a minute for a dollar, but there's no way that's a minute. Women are shoving whatnots into their whatnot.
Mr. Giuliani, that is not what Times Square is like anymore.
Are you calling me a liar?
No, I'm just saying.
Because if you're calling me a liar, I will sue you for the millions of dollars that I so desperately need. By I mean New York City.
New York City desperately needs, I get it. Wait a second, though. You've cleaned up Times Square. It's like Disneyland now.
Maybe for you. Maybe you see a woman strapped to leather stirrups performing a ping pong show while a pimp plays dice with my nephew in the bathroom, and you think, oh, this is the happiest place on earth. Where's Mickey? That's you, Dave.
That's
I know how your mind works.
I'm telling you, the word is that you're not describing present day Times Square. That's not Times Square, Mr. Mayor.
Listen,
that's not Times Square.
I most certainly am describing present day Times Square, and in fact, I'm looking at it right now.
Really? What are you saying?
It's everything you've heard about, but worse. Some creep just offered to pay $5. To watch a prostitute relieve herself all over my chest. What level of depravity is this city sunk to?
I don't know. I find this hard to believe.
You don't believe me?
No.
Why don't you get a stack of ones and come down to my hotel?
I don't think that's
necessary.
Staying at the
Times Square Doubletree,
where
looking
are
out
you?
The window, and right behind me on the bed is everything I just described. That's right. This is nothing short of a city in decay. All of it playing out right here on my bed, in front of my child, Andrew. It's disgusting. He should not be seeing this. I'm going to clean up this city, just like the way I'm going to have to clean up a whole bunch of baby oil once this very nice lady leaves.
Thank you, America's Mayor.
Come on down here and see it. Doubletree Hotel, they have free cookies in the lobby.
Are you sure they're free?
Okay. It better be.
Thank you, America's
Mayor. That's what they're advertising.
Thank you, America's Mayor Rudy Giuliani.
9/11.
9/11, yes. 9/11 to you. 9/11 to you too, Mr. Mayor. Well, that was special to speak with America's Mayor Rudy Giuliani. What an honor. Well.